train to the end.
I grew up in bro culture. Sports and music, both having one thing in common, treating women like sexual objects. When I was young, I never thought about it as being anything other than normal. You know, women were here for our sexual enjoyment. Almost every guy I knew thought like that. And really, has anything changed today?
One or two steps above prostitution.
So where do guys get the idea that women are playthings, eye candy, and sexual objects for our enjoyment?
Larry, watch this. Hey girls, actually, it's down low.
The answer is, quite honestly, everywhere.
Women, sports, beer, gadgets, clothes. Maxim, the best thing to happen to men since women. Introducing Maxim, the new magazine for men who aren't afraid to be men and are proud of it.
In the music video world, men and women inhabit very different roles. Women are taught to be submissive and sexual, while men are shown to be in control, physically powerful, and having as many sex partners as possible.
Boy, let me show you how to make that crack, how to spend that money, how to make that back. Girl, let me show you how to hit that strip, how to get that dick, don't give back.
And so for many kids, these stars are role models who tell boys how to be men. And beyond the lure of drugs, money, and fame, an alpha male, by the measurement of music videos, is a man who possesses and controls women. In this world, men never view women as equals. Rather, women are objects to use sexually, to show other men that you have power. But it is important to note, this womanizing attitude is not a black thing, or a Latino thing. This is a man thing. We find it across all cultural backgrounds. In today's culture, it's difficult for boys to avoid the message that women are pornographic playthings. Everywhere they look, boys are hit with this concept.
So do you guys want to do a three-way?
Now are you talking about you having sex with the both of us at the same time?
Yes.
The images feed the male libido with the idea that women constantly crave sex, whether they seem like it or not. In the pornified world, which is the world we are in, boys and men learn that women love to be sexually objectified. This is a world where we are taught that a woman saying no means she is flirting with you, teasing you. She wants it. Now, adolescent boys have been curious about and attracted to pornography since its inception. But the emergence of internet porn has allowed it to stream into the lives of boys like never before. Many kids have personal computers that allow porn delivery right into their bedrooms, unseen by mom and dad. And with internet access comes increased usage and increased problems.
When my time on earth is gone and my activities here are past, I want they bury me upside down and my critics can kiss my
I'm not sure what's funny about rape. Yet if you see some comedians or watch certain TV shows, you'll find rape jokes served up as regular fare. Take Fox TV mega hit Family Guy, where rape jokes play well to their largely teen male audience.
Grim news from Daytona, Florida, where the remains of three female college students were found near a local nightclub. Reports suggest that all three were violated sexually before being brutally murdered.
Oh man, see that? Everybody's getting laid but me.
I'm sure if McFarlane had experienced the rape and murder of his mother, wife, or daughter, he would never have written a joke like this. The thing is, McFarlane is talented and funny, but he's also smart enough to know that rape jokes sell, especially to young male audiences. Who cares if young men continue to see sexual assault as a joke? It makes money, doesn't it?
Light beer, please.
Sure. Do you care how it tastes?
Nah, I don't care how it tastes.
Okay, well, when you start caring, put down your purse and I'll give you a Miller Lite.
What all masculinity cops share is the desire and ability to remind boys and men about the rules of manhood, to give out verbal and behavioral citations when guys break the rules. And so, for instance, a male athlete caught crying might be confronted and judged for acting like a girl. A guy who doesn't like binge drinking at a party when everyone else is may be labeled a wuss. A guy who doesn't like football and who would rather read or do anything remotely academic may be called a fag. The boy who doesn't feel like doing something dangerous may be called a pussy. These are just a few of the rules of manhood, which tell us to hold in our emotions, as expressiveness is branded female, something worthy of insult.
And that's why yellow makes me sad, I think.
That's interesting. You know what makes me sad?
You do! Maybe we should chug on over to Mamby Pamby Land, where maybe we can find some self-confidence for you, you jackwagon!